to my channel. So yeah, today I am trying to recreate one of the trending videos on YouTube, and that is none other than Sonamkapoor's 90s Bollywood style makeup look. Now most of the YouTubers have done it. I might be the last one to do it, so I'm trying to recreate it. I'm just trying. I don't know whether I could justify or bring justice to the look, because you know, I have a very different face structure than hers. She has a very sculpted face, a very good skin, and of course international brands to play with. But I am going to do it with most of the Indian brands, and so instead of wasting much time, let's get started. So here I have the video in front of me. Like, I'll be keeping it in front and I'll try to recreate it. Now in the video, while watching it, I didn't find Sonam doing her eyebrows, and that's maybe, she of course has a beautiful eyebrows, defined eyebrows, but I did my eyebrows off the camera, a little bit of it. So let's get started. Okay, so first she does her skincare. She starts with skincare. We all do it. So, and after watching this video, I just realized that I don't have a serum. Like, not a day serum, of course. I have night serum. So, I'm not going to use that night serum right now. But yeah, I just have this, what do you call it? Yehavadam serum from Face Shop. Like, I got it in my working woman's kit, so I'll be using it. And yeah, I'm taking a little bit of it and applying it all over my face. Next, she takes a moisturizer after the serum. So I'm using the Garnier Wrinkle Lift cream. Now this is the first time I'm using it, not first time, but I'm using this is the first tub actually, and I'm loving it. So she takes her own like moisturizer and she just dabs all over. So I'm also going to follow the same thing, and I love this moisturizer. Like, I don't know where was I not knowing about this moisturizer. She uses a sunblock along with some sort of anti-pollution drop, which of course I don't have, but yeah, I do have the Lotus sunscreen here. It's the Safe Sun Mag Gel, so I'll be taking a little bit of it and yeah, apply it. After her skincare, she uses a orange corrector to correct all the things like the dark circles and everything. So I'll be using this from e.l.f. I don't have any other orange corrector, so I'll be using this. After orange corrector, she uses a concealer. So here I am using the Maybelline Age Rewind Concealer, and yeah, and then she jumps over to a foundation, a very, not a heavy foundation, but a very sheer coverage foundation, because she says she has a beautiful skin, like healthy skin, because she drinks a lot of water and everything. Like, I really like her advice, whatever she gave on the channel. Foundation, she uses her own foundation, like some match that she has been using from abroad. And yeah, I have the normal one, like the Maybelline Matte Plus Poreless. Yeah, Maybelline Fit Me Foundation in the shade 322. This is a bit darker on my skin. But yeah, nevertheless, I like my foundation to be dark than to be white. Yeah, I'm just taking a little bit of it and then I'll dot it and blend it. So just like her, I have also blended my foundation, and okay, I have skipped one part. Like, she puts coconut oil on her lips. Frankly speaking, I don't have a coconut oil and I don't put coconut oil on my lips, so I have to skip that. And instead of that, I think I'm not getting it, I use the Mamaearth lip balm, and that's it. So after her foundation, she uses a loose powder. So here I have a loose powder and it's from Sugar. And yeah, now we will also use this loose powder. But what does she say is that before applying her powder, she does get rid of those lines under her eyes. Yeah, we all have it. And then she puts the powder. So I'll take a brush. She also has, I think, a similar kind of brush. So I'm just taking it and applying it. So after her face, she goes to her eyes and she does a brown smoky eye, little bit of smoky eye look. So she uses a brown pencil from NARS. So of course I don't have NARS and someone is at the door. So yeah, I'm back, and yeah, she uses a brown pencil from NARS. So I'm using this from a brown gel eyeliner from Bella Vaste. I really don't understand like how to use this mirror, you know. Anyways, so she just puts a little bit on her lid. So next she uses the Hoola bronzer from Benefit to just smudge her eyeliner. So I'll be using this from Makeup Revolution. It's the Ultra Bronze, and I'll be using the bronzing shade here and just smudge my. After smudging her brown eyeliner, she goes for a kajal pencil. So here I'm using from Sugar Cosmetics, it's the Stroke of Genius Heavy Duty Coal. So she not only applies it in her waterline, but also on the, what do you say, the upper waterline also. So yeah, I'll be doing the same. So after applying the kajal, she goes for an eyeshadow. It's not an eyeshadow, but she wants some shimmer things on her eyelid. And so I'm not going for any eyeshadow as well. I'm just taking this highlighter thing from Sugar Cosmetics. It's Champagne Champion, and I'm just going to dab a little bit on my lids. It looks awesome, right? So after that, she describes like she has a very narrow face, so she goes heavy on blushes instead of contouring, which is just the opposite of me. Like, I go very low on blushes and heavy on bronzing my face. But yeah, we are recreating that look. So she uses a pink shade, and now I'll be using this pink here from Sugar face palette, and she just smiles and dabs a lot of blush. Yeah, I'll try to do that. Let's see how. Now that's a lot of blush for me. Actually, She does uses a lot of blush, and after blush she goes for a little bit of bronzing her face, a little bit of contouring. Thank God she contoured her face. Like, I'll be using the same like palette from Makeup Revolution, and she uses the same like Hoola bronzer from Benefit. And yeah, I love this part, giving a little bit of shape to my face, some dimension. I love bronzing my face. After just bronzing her face, what does she do is that she takes the same bronzer and, you know, she puts it like, just gives a depth to her crease line, which I really like. Like, I have hooded eyes, so I need to do that to give a good dimension to my eyes. After doing this, she takes a clean brush and just, you know, blends everything with a clean brush. And then, so then she goes for a highlighter thing, and she uses a highlighter palette which has three highlighter in it. But I'll be using the same sugar one which I applied on my eyelids. And yeah, I'll be applying it like wherever I mostly apply. I'm really liking the eye makeup. Like, it's so easy and it looks so refined. It's very easy, and that's the reason why I went ahead to recreate this. Like, not all the recreations are easy enough. So yeah, she uses a lots of highlighter, of course she will, and I too love using highlighter. After this, she curls her lashes with a eyelash curler, and then she applies mascara. So here I have an eyelash curler, and the mascara I'll be using is this from Maybelline, Total Temptation. So let me just grab my mirror, and I'm having a hard time using this mirror anyways. So, but it's a big one, you see. So I'll be curling my lashes. And definitely it gives a woof to your, like, when you apply the mascara, it definitely helps. But you know, every time I forget using this, like, I have to literally find it. It was somewhere behind the stash. Like, I probably never use it. Like, I love to use it, but then I forget to use it. And then the mascara. So while applying mascara, she just closes her eyes and applying mascara. I have never done that, and because I'm scared like I'll like damage this area, so I'll be applying mascara as I do, like opening my eyes. And that's how I'm going to do it. So after this, she uses some lipstick from NARS. So here I have a bunch of like red lipsticks. I have a very few red lipsticks, so I'm just like skeptical which one to use. Like, I have this Creeper from ColourPop, as well as I have this Nykaa, this lip shade. So I think today I'll go with the Nykaa. So let's just use this. I hope it's just the perfect shade as hers. By the way, this is Mishti from Nykaa Matte Tula. So let me just apply. So after the lipstick, like you can see, I have parted my hairs, and yeah, she applies a liquid sindoor, and here I have one from Lotus. I think I need a mirror. So after the sindoor, she says a perfect thing like without a bindi, this makeup look or this sindoor is incomplete. So I totally agree with her. So I do have a bindi, I do have bindis, but here she doesn't have bindi and she uses the same brown pencil, I think, to do a little bit of bindi. So I'll be using this brown pencil and like I wear bindi here in middle of my eyebrows, but she does a little bit higher. So I'll be doing it here. I don't know how I look. So last but not the least, she wears a silver jhumki from her mother. Like the jhumki was very, very beautiful. But I did have a similar jhumki, but it was not silver. It was an oxidized one, but I'm not finding it. It was very similar to that jhumki. I think I might have lost it or I have kept it in Kolkata back there. But I found one jhumki here, so I'll be wearing this one and try to match. Yeah, I won't be able to match, but still, I'm just trying. So this is the jhumki. So that's the look, guys. Like she had her hairs in a bun, but I cannot make a bun. I can do a ponytail, but it looks very weird when I do ponytail because I have a big huge face but very little hair, so I'm not tying it up. So this is the look. I really like the look. Like it's very Indian, very easygoing. Like we married women, yeah, maybe we won't use this shimmer and all, but frankly speaking, this is something that you can go with a sari, wear a sari, like we Bengalis wear that white red par sari. So it would go fabulous with those type of saris, or it looks great. Like it was a very easy tutorial and I like the makeup look. Do tell me whether you liked it or not. So that was the video, guys. I tried to recreate her 90s Bollywood style look. So if you like it, give it a big thumbs up. And if you like my content, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to hit the notification bell just beside the subscription button so that you get notified every time I post a new video. So that's it, guys. Bye-bye for now and see you in my next video.